friends, welcome to Damo Education. If not yet subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell icon. So in this session, we are going to discuss our second question. The sides of a right angle triangle PQR. Let's going to take PQR from this point PQR. So these are the triangle and right angle at Q. So you can take it as angle Q is 90 degrees. Then PQ, they are given that, what is the given data, write it first one. So they are given the data, PQ will be equal to 7 cm, then PR will be equal to 25 cm, then angle Q will be equal to 90 degrees. So we are already taking this is angle Q 90 degrees, and then respectively then find the tan P. So what we need to find it here is tan P minus tan R. So we can go with the two methods for this, direct method and another method. That is with the sine you can go. So let's going to take tan P. So what is the tan theta formula? So tan theta will be equal to opposite side to theta, opposite side to theta. Theta is nothing but your angle. So angle, this one spelling is, you can take like this. So this is angle. So opposite side to adjacent side, opposite side to adjacent side to theta. So this is the formula. Let's take this formula as a base and write it this one. So they are given that PQ. So PQ will be equal to 7 cm. Then PR will be equal to 25 cm. Then what is the angle Q? So, but we know this is the base and this is hypotenuse. So capital H, let's going to take this is hypotenuse. And this is, this one we have to know. So from Pythagoras theorem, what you can say here is, from Pythagoras theorem you can write condition like this. So from Pythagoras theorem you can write one condition. What is that? The hypotenuse square will be equal to sum of the remaining two sides. So hypotenuse square plus square of the remaining two sides, that is PQ square plus QR square. So what is P? This one has square is nothing but PR square. Hypotenuse is, that implies PR square, that will be equal to PQ square plus QR square. So we need to find the QR. So QR means, let's going to take QR square will be equal to PR square minus PQ square, and QR will be equal to, if you shift to the square to this side, we will get it as square root. So that is PR square minus PQ square. So let's going to substitute the values in this, then we can calculate it here. So what is the value you can substitute? So QR is nothing but, let's going to take QR is nothing but square root of PR is equals to, what is that? So PR will be equal to, PR will be equal to 25 square minus PQ is nothing but 7 square. So that is square root of 25 whole square is 625, then 7 sevens are 49. So if you subtract from 629 to 49, we will get it as 576. So 576, you can write it in the format of 24 whole square, and square square root will going to cancel. So these two will going to cancel, then what we will get it? QR will be equal to 24 centimeter. So what is the value of this 24 centimeter? So like this, we need to find this, and we are going to calculate what is tan P and tan R. Now we will see the actual one. What is tan P minus tan R? So let's going to write tan P minus tan R. So what is tan P and tan R? So here angles are P and R. So for that we have to select what is tan P. So for that tan P, let's going to write tan P means, what is that tan P? So angle, let's consider the angle here. So for this angle, opposite side by adjacent side. So as I told, opposite side by adjacent side. Adjacent side. So what is the opposite side here? The opposite side to angle P here is QR. QR whole divided by adjacent side is PQ. So PQ. So QR is equals to 24, then PQ will be equal to 7. So this is tan P. Let's write same as it is tan R. So let's consider the tan R here. For this, opposite side is, so same formula for this also, for this opposite side is nothing but PQ, then whole divided by adjacent side is QR. So same this one, Q R. So PQ will be equal to, what is that? So adjacent side for this. So a PQ and QR. So let's going to take it this one. PQ as, what is this PQ? So PQ is nothing but 7. Then what is this? RP will be equal to 24. So this is the one. So let's going to substitute all these values here and let's going to find. So tan P minus tan R will be equal to, what is that here? Tan P is equals to 24 by 7 minus 7 by 24. So what we will get it here is, let's going to take LCM, 24 into 7. What we will get it? So 24 into 7, 150. So 168. So 24 into 7, 168. So this is the LCM of both. So let's going to multiply 24 with the 24 here. 7 is there for that. 7 into 7. So what value we will get it here? So 24 4s are 576 whole minus 49 by, what is that? 168. So let's going to move on this and going to cancel. So 576 minus 49, we will get it 527 by 168. So this is our answer. Is there any possibility to cancel? We can going to cancel it. Now we are going to check it our next method. What is that? For tan P and tan R. So for tan P, you can write it as sin P by cos P. So that one you can write it. And tan R, you can write it in the format of sin R by cos R. Or sin R by cosine R. So what is the sin P here? So let's going to write sin P will be, so what is sin P? Opposite side by hypotenuse. So for P angle, what is the opposite side? That is RQ. So RQ whole divided by hypotenuse. And what is cos P? So cosine P will be equal to adjacent side. So for P angle, what is the adjacent side? PQ by hypotenuse. So these values we will going to measure it and we're going to write it. So RQ is equal to 24 by hypotenuse is 25, and this one will be equal to adjacent side PQ will be 7 by 25. So this is cos, cosine P and sine P. Then let's going to find what is the value of tan R in the format of sine R. So sine R for that opposite side, for the angle, consider the angle R. For that opposite side will be equal to, for, from this, so for R angle, what is the opposite side? PQ. So PQ by hypotenuse, that is capital H. So PQ is equal to 7 by hypotenuse is 25. Let's find out cosine R. So cos R will be adjacent side is nothing but for the R, RQ is the adjacent side by hypotenuse. RQ is equal to 24 by 25. So sine, so let's going to write it sin tan P. So what is tan P will be equal to? So tan P will be sin P, that is 24 by 25 whole divided by cosine P will be equal to 7 by 25. And what you can take it here is next one, tan R. So tan R will be equal to cosine R, that is 7 by 25 whole divided by cosine R, that is 24 by 25. So let's going to cancel all these values. So this one 25, 25 will going to cancel. Here also 25, 25 will going to cancel. Then what you can say here, tan P will be equal to, so 24 by 7. So tan P will be equal to 24 by 7. Tan R will be equal to 7 by 24. Let's move on to this and find out what is the solution. That is tan P minus tan R. That will be 24 by 7 minus 7 by 24. If you take LCM, what we will get it? So 7 into 24 is nothing but 168. And here we are going to multiply with the 24, 24 as we done previously. So here 24 is there. What need to multiply with the number in order to get 168? That is 7. So what we will get it here? 576 minus 149 whole divided by 168. So if you take subtraction, we will get it 527 whole divided by 168. So this is the value of that tan P minus tan R. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.